kingdom. Helmet, my friend! You are your death. Oh, heart, friend! I will not live after this. I'm more of an ancient Roman than a Dane. He's yet some liquor left. Poison, do your work. My lord, you live! My lord, you're dead. My lord, you live! You're dead. My lord, stay!
Horatius, I will not live much longer.
No, please, don't.
I will not live much longer.
No,
Horatius,
no. Horatius!
I will not live much longer.
The poison is taking over this vessel. So please, my friend.
What? What?
No, 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 no. I'll follow you. I'll follow you, my friend. I will.
Goodbye, cruel world.
No! Horatius, if you ever loved me, absent yourself from eternal happiness a while longer and endure this harsh word to tell my story.
I will, my friend. I will.
And do it now!
Now?
Yes, now!
But everybody's dead.
Not to them. I want you to tell my story to them. They need to know. They paid for a ticket.
Well,
And make it a comedy!
Comedy?
Yes, I don't want people to be depressed by listening to my story. Make it a comedy. The rest is silence.
Comedy. He wants me to tell his story as a comedy. A comedy.
Yes! What's so difficult? Last year you did a tragedy. This year is a comedy.
But the story of Hamlet, the Prince of Denmark, is not a comedy.
It will be after you tell it.
But Shakespeare wrote the tragedy.
Shakespeare is dead! He won't mind! He's been dead for the last 400 years! Do you think he really cares? So come on, let's start with a nice musical number.
A musical number?
Start!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Hamlet, the comical story of the Prince of Denmark.
Yeah.
how painful this is. But trust me, we shall see better days.
Oh, my dear brother!
Whoa. That funeral wedding wine was strong, huh?
Well, it's time to move from sorrow and from celebration, for we must continue with our own lives. My former sister-in-law, now our queen, Rare.
Meow. Woo, woo, woo!
And myself want to express our gratitude for your loyalty and for your support. Well, what's next? That is, my prime minister, your mother, says you have a request to make.
Yes, my king.
Well, let's be calm, Laertes.
My liege, I seek your leave to return to France. I came to attend the funeral, and of course, stay to your wedding. Once again, I must congratulate you for the wonderful party. But now, I must return to France to pursue my interests there.
Of course you have, Laertes. But have you your mother's permission? Apollonia?
Oh yes, my lord, he has. After much petition, finally received my permission.
Well then, make the most of your youth, Laertes. Return to France and pursue as many interests as you can, because you only live once. Right, my love?
Of course, my sweetie.
Hamlet, my nephew and my son, one too many if you ask me. I'd rather be a cloudy nephew than a shining sun. Precisely, Hamlet, why are you still so gloomy with a cloud hanging over you? There is no cloud, Claudius.
Oh, Hamlet, he's right. You're so gloomy, you must lighten up a bit. You know, I hate black, it's so negative and so out of fashion.
So out of fashion.
I respect the king who is your father now.
Woo, woo, woo!
You can't spend your whole life with the eyes to the ground remembering your noble father and crying and crying and crying! Everything that lives must die, passing through nature to eternity. So get over it!
I can't get over it, Mother! That's why I wear black and I'm gloomy! Because I can't get over it! I can't! Hamlet, you're so good and such a sweet son to mourn your father like this. But remember, your father lost his father. Who lost his father?
Yes.
Who lost his father? Who lost his father? Who lost his father?
That's not the point!
Each son has had to mourn his father for a certain period. But overdoing it is just stubborn. It's not manly, and it's not what our God wants. So, as your highness, I order you to stop this mourning of yours. Stop thinking of me as your new dad. For love is any father loves his son. And that's it!
But uncle!
No one good to you! I'm your highness!
Or daddy.
You choose. And your plans of going back to Wittenberg are not what I want. So you stay here!
Hamlet, stay! Don't you love your mother anymore? My Gucci, Gucci.
Fine, I will stay. Oh, that's the right answer, Hamlet. It shows you love. Stay with us in Denmark. My queen.
Yeah.
Hamlet's agreeing to stay. Makes me so happy. Let's put some flowers in my brother's tomb and toast in his memory. Let's go. Bring the wine.
Are you coming, Hamlet?
Yes, yes. I'll see you in a minute.
Are you okay?
Yes, of course I'm okay. I'll see you in a minute.
Okay. Are you sure?
Yes, of course I'm sure. I'll see you in a minute. I just need to be alone for a minute, okay?
Are you really sure?
I'm okay.
100%
sure. 100% sure.
Really?
Okay, I'm okay.
Okay, bye.
I'm so not okay.
This is
solid flesh would melt. Melt and resolve itself into a tomb. Or that God had not made a law against suicide. I'm a stoner of hate.
Don't you see I'm busy?
Busy doing what?
Never mind. Why have you interrupted my... It doesn't matter. Speak.
Well, the king,
your father,
wants to know if you're any of your father's armors.
My father's armors? Yes.
He was cleaning the closets to put his stuff in. And he wants to know if you had any of your father's things before he throws them away.
Tell my uncle...
Your father.
Tell the king that I will be getting my father's armor.
Thank you, Prince Hardwood.
Your Majesty!
My Lord!
Prince Hamlet!
Sir!
My Lord!
So, why have you left Wittenberg?
We came to see your father's funeral!
And your mother's wedding!
Yes, but originally we went to the funeral, then we stayed because the wedding, you know, it was...
Say it!
No, wait.
Come on, say it! Because my mother's wedding came very shortly after the funeral of my father! Very, very shortly! We're so close! They use the leftovers of the funeral banquet as appetizers in the wedding!
I knew it!
Oh, I mean, what an awesome king was your father.
More than that. He was a great human being. Perfect in everything. And now he's gone. And I'll never see him again.
We saw him last night.
What? So who?
The king.
The king, my father?
The king, your father.
The king Joseph Aurelius is my father?
The king Joseph Aurelius is your father.
The king Joseph Aurelius is my dead father?
The king Joseph Aurelius is your dead father.
Yes! The king Joseph Aurelius is your dead father, but you were hallucinating.
Wait!
Are you telling me that my father was in your hallucination? Typical of him.
No! We were not hallucinating, and we saw your father last night.
The ghost of your father, to be precise. And he doesn't look very happy.
What? Tell me about it.
After midnight, we saw a figure that looked very much like your father. In full armor, from head to toe, toe to head.
He just appeared and marched past us with a lot of goo.
Yeah.
Very cool ghost, if you ask me.
Cool ghost, cool ghost.
But where did this happen?
On the walls of the castle.
Why did you not speak to it?
We did, sir, but it didn't answer. Well, it raised its head once, as if it was about to,
To what?
To speak, but then...
But then, she totally ruined everything with a big R. of ruining everything. She started laughing and the ghost left, which, by the way, I would have done too if someone laughed at me as she did.
I was very nervous and scared. I only laugh when I am nervous and scared. I'm sorry, Prince, now that I didn't mean to offend your dead father. He's just that.
Shut up!
It's very strange.
I totally swear to God it is true, sir.
Yes, we thought you had to know about it.
Indeed. I must meet the ghost. Will you take me to the place you saw it?
Of course, my lord.
Tonight?
Tonight.
It was Hermes' day.
Aye, my lord.
From head to toe?
Yes, from top to bottom, sir.
Big sword, my lord.
But you saw the face.
Oh, yes. The helmet beat her up.
Was he frowning?
Look more sad than angry.
Okay, we shall go tonight. If that ghost is really my father, we shall speak to it. And if it's a demon, we shall run very, very quickly. Now, I must ask you to keep this as a secret. I'll see you again tonight.
Fine, my lord.
My lord, will you be okay?
I don't think so.
Okay, see you later.
Is this ghost related to this pain I'm feeling? I suspect some foul play.
Very strange.
I know he loved his father and now his uncle and mother. What? I was going to say his uncle and mother. What? I was going to say his uncle and mother are married. That's all. And that is a bit weird, but believe me, Hamlet was weird without that.
Oh, but okay. He's so cute.
Are you listening? Girls, can you please tell her what we have been discussing about Hamlet and how we concluded it's not good for her?
Yeah, I mean,
Hamlet is not for you.
Not for you.
When things are not meant to be,
they're not meant to be.
I mean, remember what happened to Juliet, right? We told her Romeo was not good for her. But did she listen to us?
No.
And set us
tragedy.
Simona, you speak from resentment because your boyfriend is a mad jealous psycho.
What?
But not like my Hamlet. You don't understand. He might look sad and even gloomy, you know, but oh, you don't understand. Hamlet is so...
What a pity. Right, girls?
What a pity.
So, we're just talking with Ophelia about her sweet prince, right?
Stop it, Simona! She's bullying
her. We're not. Come on, everyone knows about you and Hamlet.
Hamlet!
Shut up! It's nothing.
No, it's not. Come on, you were just singing about it. We're leaving. Bye, Laertes.
Bye, girls.
See you in Paris.
What is all this about Hamlet, sister? Are you in love?
Well, he has been sending me presents, and before King Joseph Paris died, we did it for a time, but it's not.
But nothing.
What?
You must forget him.
No way, why?
Why? Ophelia, listen to me. You must consider all this about Hamlet as a big filtration. It's a temporary phase. It's sweet, but his affection will fade after 1 minute.
1 minute?
Not a second more. Ophelia, Hamlet is a prince. He belongs to the royal family. And do you know what that means? It means that he's a slave to his family obligations. It means that he says he loves you now, but he will grow to be a king. Therefore, his decisions will be state decisions. He can simply make personal choices for himself. His choices must agree with what the nation wants.
They have to vote about it.
No, it doesn't matter what he promised to you. He will not keep that promise.
Oh, but he's a prince. He will be king.
Princes and kings never keep their promises. And knowing Hamlet, he will promise anything to get into your bed.
Laertes!
It is true. Hamlet is a man, so watch out.
You're a man too!
That's what I know! Ophelia, just keep your love under control and don't let yourself become a target of his lust.
Target of his lust? How can I become a target of his lust?
Simply exposing your beauty to the moon at night is risky enough, so you don't have to expose yourself to him.
Okay, I will be careful, I promise you that. Ah! You're still here? You will be late. You want to be late, to lose the sheep. Do you know that if you lose the sheep, you will have to wait here 3 weeks? 3 weeks! And do you know what 3 weeks are? 21 days!
Okay, madam, I'm going.
Wait! You can't leave without my blessing. You will be crossing the sea. You need my blessing. If you drown and you die, you will need my blessing to get into heaven. Don't you want to get into heaven?
Yes.
Shh! Don't change the subject. Here, I give you my blessing. And just try to remember a few rules of life. Don't say what you're thinking, and don't be too quick to act on what you think. Be friendly to people, but don't overdo it.
Once you've tested out your friends and found them trustworthy, hold on to them. But don't waste your time shaking hands with every new guy you meet. Don't be too quick to pick up a fight, but once you're in one, kick hard. Listen to many people, but talk to a few. Hear everyone's opinion, but preserve your judgment. Spend all you can afford in clothes. Remember, you're in France, and there is very important how you dress. Eat properly, and always remember to take your handkerchief. Now go, 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 or you'll be late.
Thank you, Mother. Bye, sister. Remember what I have told you.
I will, brother, but I think you're exaggerating. What did he tell you, Ophelia? Oh,
something about Hamlet.
So it's true. I knew it, I knew it, I knew it. Oh, I didn't want to believe it at first, but now it's true. Shame, shame, shame. What is going on between you two? Tell me the truth.
Nothing. He has just offered a lot of affection lately.
Affection? He's been showing you a lot of affection, and you call that nothing? You're talking like some innocent girl who doesn't understand the ways of the world.
But Mother, he always talk about love in an honorable fashion.
Love? He played that card. This is very serious.
He's made the holiest vows to me to back up what he says, and I believe him.
What kind of foolish girl are you? This is a castle. He's a prince. These are the Middle Ages. Vows amount to nothing here. They are just drops for stupid birds. Trust me, I know when a mind's on fire. He'll swear anything. Do not mistake that for true love.
But Mother!
Silence, Ophelia. I know what I'm talking about. Don't waste your time with Hamlet. Don't believe his love vows. They're like flashy pimps who wear nice clothes to lead women into filthy acts. Hamlet is bad, 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 bad. Hamlet is bad. Now come with me.
Thank you. And in darkness I walk, take ribbon, take ribbon. That's the way to save my soul. Take ribbon, take ribbon. That's the way to save my soul. Oh my son, your ankle lips, that incestuous and adulterous animal, with his clever words and fancy gift, he seduced my wife. She's weak and was seduced by your ankle. While I was sleeping in the orchard, poison into my ear. Yes, he did that.
I knew it! Oh, most pernicious woman! Oh, villain, them brutes of vicious, horrible villain!
My lord, who are you talking about?
No one.
Whoa, what was that? Amazing! That is what I call amazing with the A of amazing.
My lord, what did the ghost tell you?
Nothing.
Nothing?
What? The ghost told me that I know you'll talk.
No, we won't. We are very discreet. You can tell us.
Well, the ghost, he told me that. No, you reveal it!
No, we won't!
Yes, you will!
No, we won't!
Yes, you will!
No, we won't!
Okay! The ghost, he told me that there is a horrible villain in Denmark!
Really? You don't need a ghost returning from the grave to tell you that, sir! This country is full of horrible villains!
What? Full!
Everywhere!
Yes, you are right. I must leave now. I have to go to pray.
My lord, what is wrong with you? You're really kind of weird, but now you're acting crazy. Are you okay?
I'm sorry if I offended you, my friend.
There is no offense.
Yes, there is! There is a lot of offense! A big, huge offense! Do you know the size of the offense? Imagine the worst offense you can imagine. Then double it, and that is not even close to the size of the offense. My friend, I need a favor.
I have no money.
Of course, my lord.
I must ask you to keep what you've seen here as a secret.
You have our word.
Swear it.
Of course.
Swear!
We swear, we swear. Cross our heart, we love you, Dad.
Thanks, Dad.
OMG! What was that?
That was unbelievably strange.
There are more things in heaven and earth, Horatius, that you've dreamt in your philosophy.
What?
What?
That I need another favor. No matter how strangely I act, because I may find it appropriate to act a little crazy in the near future. So, no matter how strangely I act, you must never let on to tell anyone what you've seen here tonight. Not a word, nor a comment, nor a gesture. Understood?
Yes. Yes.
Swear it!
Again?
Swear!
Okay,
now leave!
My lord, are you sure you're the one?
Leave!
Okay.
Oh, unhappy ghost! I will help you rest in peace! I will kill my uncle! Maybe I should find a little more evidence before doing that. Killing a king is a big thing, and I only have the testimony of a ghost.
Why is it so hard to make a decision? Why can't I just
kill him
and smile?
Excuse me, Hamlet?
What is it now?
I just wanted to return all these presents and letters again.
What? Why?
Because you're a priest, this is a castle, these are the Middle Ages, and you cannot keep your promises because Denmark has to vote. And because you have a filthy man like my brother.
I don't understand. You don't want my letters.
Yes! No, I don't want them.
Fine then. No letters, no presents, no nothing! Fantastic! Fantastic! Although I don't understand why you don't want my letters.
For I have no brothers, I take no naps.
Well, are you okay?
And stop asking me if I'm okay. Of course I'm okay. I have never been better in my life. I'm so okay that I'm super okay. Could I be able to do this if I wasn't okay? I feel good. Whoa! That is how okay I am. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go chase my imaginary friend. Wait for me, unicornicus!
Hamlet, wait!
But did you explain to him that it was urgent?
Yes, my lady.
And that we were doing spring cleaning?
Yes, my lady.
Well, if he doesn't claim any of the animals by tomorrow, give them to charity.
To charity?
You're right! We better sell them. You can keep 20%, but the rest is for me. What is going on, Ophelia?
Oh, mother! Something strange and scary just happened. As you told me, I returned all the presents and letters Prince Hamlet gave me. And when I did, he reacted very strangely. He shouted! He threw the letters into the air as he danced in a madly fashion. Then he sang a horrible song and left chasing an imaginary friend.
Chasing an imaginary friend?
Yes!
Then there is no doubt about it. I'm afraid I was wrong, Ophelia. Hamlet wasn't playing with your feelings. That boy is madly in love with you.
But you told me his vows were false.
I know, but crazy dancing, horrible songs, and chasing imaginary friends are all clear symptoms of love craziness. That boy is madly in love with you, and that is dangerous. Love is a violent emotion that makes people self-destruct. That's why I never loved anyone, not even your father. Now come with me.
Oh, mother.
Rosencrantz, Guildenstern!
General, I am Rosencrantz and she's Guildenstern, my lord.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. People tend to get confused all the time.
Oh, yes, they call me Rosencrantz millions of times. I think it is because our names sound alike and we look alike.
Whatever!
Rosencrantz and Guildenstern, the king and I wanted to see you for a long time now. Isn't it so, Miranda?
Oh, yes. My lady and the king, I wanted to see you for a long time.
We need your help right away. You've probably heard about the change that has come over Hamlet. How his behavior and manner are somehow stranger.
You mean that he sings of his own and runs around chasing an imaginary friend called Unicorn?
Oh, did you hear that, Miranda? He's running around chasing an imaginary friend called
Unicornicus. I told my lady, but my lady didn't want to listen.
We heard. Not much, but we heard. I can't imagine what has made him so alike himself, rather than his father's death.
Yes, you're right. His father's death and the silent wedding are enough to mess up anyone's head.
Oh, I told you it was too soon. I told you we had to wait.
Gertrude, it was your idea to marry just after the funeral so we could reuse the funeral catering.
I am completely sure that our marriage is not the cause of Hamlet's insane behavior. Mother's happiness is never the cause of unhappiness in his son, right?
You're right, Your Majesty. Silly of me for having mentioned it. As a matter of fact, Hamlet loved the wedding.
He couldn't stop dancing.
Party.
I'm sure there must be some other hidden reason for all this.
Right. So I am asking you to stay a while at court and spend some time with him. See if you can get Hamlet to have some fun. And find out if there is anything in particular that is bothering him, so we can set about trying to fix it.
You want us to spy on him?
And spying is bad.
Bad.
You're not spying. You're just recovering information for a desperate mother who wants to help her son. Mothers never spy. Right, Miranda?
Oh, yes. Mothers never spy. They find out in mysterious way.
Of course we will help, Your Majesty.
Thank you, Rosencrantz and Guildenstern.
It's Guildenstern and Rosencrantz.
Miranda, take Rosencrantz and Guildenstern to see my son immediately.
Over here, please.
Your Majesty, I know what is wrong. Hamlet, and you were right. It was not the wedding.
Apollonia, please speak!
Sir and madam, to make grand speeches about what majesty is, what service is, or why day is day, night is night, and time is time, it's just a waste of a lot of day, night, and time. Therefore, since the essence of wisdom is not talking very much, I get right to the point here, and I will sing to you what is wrong with Prince Hamlet.
What are you talking about?
Oh. I remember when, I remember when he lost.
As I was saying...
And you keep interrupting me!
Your friends Rosencrantz and Guildenstern are here, sir.
And now you tell me! Why didn't you say that before instead of chit-chatting about my book? You're a strange person, Miranda!
Well, I've been working for the Queen for a long time, if that was what you mean, Lord Hamlet.
You can leave now. Rosencrantz, Guilderson, I thought you have left already. I guess we share the same prison then.
Prison, my lord? What prison?
Our rooms are a bit small, but to call them a prison, I think it's too much.
Denmark is a prison.
That is not possible, because if Denmark is a prison, who guards the prison?
You're right, because if Denmark is a prison, it means we're all in. And if we're all in, it means we're all criminals. And if we're all criminals, there's no one left to be a guard, and there's no prison without a guard.
It's a figure of speech. Anyway, why have you come?
Because it's king. We came here to visit Hamlet, remember? Originally we came here because of the funeral, but then there was no wedding, but then we decided to stay here and pay him a visit.
You're right! I got confused because of
you.
Because of you. To visit you, Hamlet, so how are things? Anything you want to tell us? Love life? How's your friend Unicorn in you?
Guilderson! I'm sorry, Hamlet.
She's right. I have been acting strange lately. And that's why my uncle sent you two to spy on me.
We're not here to spy on you. We're here to cheer you up. Your mother and father, uncle, are very worried about you. We're worried about you. Where is the joyful Hamlet, the party king?
Party, 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 party.
I have a plate. But warfare, I know not. I lost all my mirth, forgone all custom of exercises. And indeed, it goes so heavily with my disposition that this goodly frame, the earth, seems to me a sterile promontory. The air, why it appears no other thing to me than a foul and pestilent congregation of vapors.
That's what we think of your opinion.
You pay for a performance, you will have performance.
You will have performance.
Don't you understand? We don't need a performance. You can keep the money.
We are a prestigious company.
Yeah, tell her.
We are masters in tragedy, comedy, history, pastoral, pastoral, comic, historical, pastoral, tragic, comic, historical, pastoral. Turn it out of the way!
By mostly comedy. That's what we do.
Will you shut up? No one is talking to you.
Excuse me, Apollonia. But what is going on here?
I'm sorry, Prince Hamlet.
Prince Hamlet? The Prince Hamlet?
Who?
You know, Prince Hamlet, the one with the question. His mother died, and soon after, his mother married his uncle. Very bad timing, if you ask me.
Hardy! I'm sorry, Your Honor.
Allow me.
Your Majesty, it seems we have a problem.
Maggie, explain.
You see, we were hired to perform at the wedding. We prepared a unique piece called Don't Call Me Uncle. Call me Dad. So sad, so sad. But let us show you the opening tableau.
Woo! Believe me, it's an incredible play with incredible music, with incredible actors, and I myself am an incredible performer with...
Listen, Mrs. Judy. Judy Shakespeare.
What?
Well, we changed this tragedy into a comedy. Why can't I change my name? Anyways. Anyways, we arrived 2 days late. The wedding is over. We have no need of a play. So I must ask you to leave.
Aww. Wait, Apollonia! I think we might need a play. Please show us.
Oh, Lord Hamlet! You will be delighted with our performance! King and Queen of all of Europe has a blood in our hearts!
Come on, make it dramatic. We dance, we like to. Now it's time for dancing.
You will be performing for the king and the queen. Can you do the murder of Gonzaga?
My lord, we are masters in tragedy, comedy, history, pastoral, pastoral, comical, historical, pastoral, tragical, comical, historical, pastoral. Of course we know the murder of Gonzaga.
Great! Miss Apollonia, see that Mrs. Shakespeare and her company have everything they need. I will be sending you some modifications I will ask you to add. Well, is that okay by you?
We usually don't change our plays with such short notice.
Of course it's okay.
Great. Follow Apollonia now. Make sure not to make fun of her. Let's see how you find this play now, dear uncle. If what I think will happen happens, it will be killing time! My friend! You can tell my uncle you were able to cheer me up! Good for you! I must leave you now. My friend Unicornicus is waiting for me. Unicornicus, I'm coming!
Well, he looks a bit better, doesn't he?
No, he doesn't. He's angry and confused. I'm sure there's something bothering him. I wonder what that could be.
Well, what did you discover?
Not much, Your Highness.
Not much! Not much as in a lot, my queen. Hamlet is confused and angry, but he refuses to say why.
And did you try to cheer him up?
We did. We introduced him to some players.
No, we didn't. We didn't introduce him to some players. They were already here for the wedding, but... Yes, we did! We introduced him to some players and he was so happy that he asked them to perform tonight.
And he asked me to beg you both to attend.
Oh, I'm so happy to hear he's so
interested. We shall attend up to
him. Oh, the court, Miranda!
Yes, madam.
There will be a play tonight and every single member of the court must be there. Tell them.
Now?
Yes! Now we have another play tonight. Therefore, you need to do it right now.
Gertrude, we have secretly arranged for Hamlet to come here tonight so that he can write to Ophelia. Her mother and I will hide and observe his behavior to determine whether it is love that is making him suffer like this.
Great plan, my dear. Ophelia! I hope that your beauty is the cause of Hamlet's insane behavior and that your virtues will help him regain his sanity. Love is such a powerful thing! Look how it changed me. I was sad and lonely and suddenly love.
Whoa, 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 whoa!
Oh,
yes. Love has changed you a lot. No doubt about that.
Very well, let's go.
Miranda!
Very well, very well. You and I, we will hide there. You stay here and wait for him. Act naturally.
Come on, let's hide. I can hear you coming.
You're right. I hear his voice. He's talking to himself. Maybe he's talking to Nicornicus, his imaginary friend.
Anyway, Ophelia here, read this book so it looks natural that you're all alone.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the middle of the play, and this is to be or not to be.
To be or not to be is the most famous soliloquy in the history of theater. But being this a special comical version of the Danish tragedy,
we have decided to transform Hamlet's famous soliloquy into a choral performatic experience.
CPE, brother!
Ladies and gentlemen, just before the interval, we present to you To be or not to be?
That is the question, bro!
Shh, shh, shh.
to sleep, by chance to dream.
And by sleep to say we end. The heartache and the thousand natural shocks that place his head to taste and consummation, devoted to be wished, hey, that's around. For in the sleep of death, but dreams may come where we have shuffled of this mortal coil, must give us pause. There's the respect that makes calamity of so long life. For who would bear the whips and scorns of time, oppressor's wrong, the lost delay, the innocence of office, and the spurn that patient merit of the unworthy takes when he himself by his wife is made with a bad bodkin. It's the dread of something after death that makes us rather bear those seals we have than to fly to others that we know not of. Thus conscience does make cowards of us all.
And asking the question.
I don't know what you're talking about.
But you were with them, I remember. They were singing, dancing, and making strange noises with their mouths like...
My lord? My lord?
What?
You know, I have been thinking.
You do that?
Well, yes. You know, if you're still upset because I returned the presents and letters you gave me, maybe I should have them back. I mean, if you really think I should have them. They were really nice presents, and I really like them. I really like them. I really like them! I like them! I like them! But my motives for returning them change. You know me. One day I want one thing, another day another.
Are you honest?
What?
Are you beautiful?
Well, yes, to the second question. And do I have an option for the first one?
What? Unicornic is my friend. It's so nice to see you. This is my friend Unicornicus. Say hello to him.
What?
Say hello to him.
Hamlet, there's no one there.
You are right, my friend. She has changed.
I have not.
Yes, you have. Your beauty changed you. Your beauty corrupted your honesty. What? Oh, yes, you can say that again. I very much loved her, but now...
No, what? I am still beautiful and honest.
Beautiful, yes. Honest? Ha! Done, my friend! That's how I feel now!
I heard nothing.
Oh, stop pretending you heard. It was clear.
But I heard nothing.
What? Yes, 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 yes. Maybe she needs to hear it from my lips. Ophelia, I don't love you. You know what? I never did.
That is not true. You gave me presents.
To deduce taxes.
You wrote me love letters.
I was practicing my language and spelling.
Why are you doing this to me?
Unicornicus, would you mind explaining it to her?
I am not talking to Unicornicus. Simply Unicornicus. One more word and you will regret it, okay? Huh.
So you see him now. Oh, you love him. You pretended he wasn't there to confuse me. Oh, you are mean.
I am sorry, Hamlet. I didn't mean to offend you, Unicornicus. I am sorry, Unicornicus. I didn't mean to offend you.
Now you mock me. Unicornicus left crying after what you said to him. Ophelia, you have no escape. Get yourself to a convent at once.
Why would I do that?
To prevent giving birth to more sinners. Listen. We are all criminals. Yes, you heard, criminals. Every one of us is a criminal. Ophelia, where's your mother?
at home?
Is she? Thea, get yourself to a convent. Thea, get yourself to a convent far away. Ophelia, get yourself to a convent far away and stay there. And if you have to marry, marry a fool, for wise men would know too much to cheat on them. Don't cry, unicorn, just wait for me.
Love! This is not love! Those are not the words of a lover. Even more, I think he hates your daughter.
Oh, no, 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 my lord. I still believe that his madness was caused by unrequited love. Ophelia, you could have been a little bit more sympathetic. All he was asking was for some, just some love.
Mother!
Shush, girl. We'll set up another encounter.
No! Enough! This is not love. There is something else here. Music! I need to think. Something is troubling his soul, and I don't believe it's love. No. And I'm beginning to suspect that it's madness either. No. That boy is not. I know what is wrong with Hamlet. Call it love, I think it's hate. I believe we must be careful and take some action before it's too late. He gives me fever. He's not crazy, he's already boiling inside. Fever, is he plotting? Master, what is in his mind? I don't think he's crazy. Hamlet's not in love. I don't know what he's planning, but something must be done with that lad. He gives me fever. He's not crazy, something is boiling inside.
And the queen is not funny!
Vanessa, you will be the prologue, and...
Judy, why do I always have to be the dying king?
Maggie, why is he playing the dying king?
Because he always plays the dying king.
You always play the dying king.
That's right, I always play the dying king.
I think it's clear by now. Do you have a problem with it?
I do, because I've always had the characters that are mutilated or tortured or die.
Well, that's because you're good at dying. You have a talent for it.
Oh, yes, you have an amazing talent to die. You have a gift, you know. And to receive slaps. Don't forget that.
Oh, yes. Nobody receives slaps as you do.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, I know. I slapped everyone in this company, didn't I? And no one, not even Olivia, and she is good, is capable of receiving a slap as you do.
Really?
Oh, of course. Only yesterday, I was telling Vanessa how good you are, right?
Yes. She said, you are the only one in the company that understands the true essence of being slapped.
Well, I do my best. But I think I'm ready for other parts. I have a very good mind.
No, you're playing the dying king.
I can tell.
No, you're playing the dying king.
Wait. I'm a good magician too. But I think I would love to play the dying king.
You see, you're a natural.
Very well. According to indications, Mrs. Apollonia gave me. We'll sit there, the car will be there, and we will be acting here. We will start with performatic intro. You and you will be the columns, you and you will be the trees, and you will be the birds. Titus will be the killer.
Yes.
Somebody has a problem with that?
I thought so. And Judy will be the angel of justice that comes at the end and destroys everything.
Whoa. Why do all the plays end up with the angel of justice just coming and destroying everything? And why does Judy always play the angel of justice?
Because I'm perfect for it! Oh. And that's justice for you! Turn over it!
Are you ready? The king and queen will be arriving at any minute now.
Everything's ready.
Horatius. I need a favor.
You don't like the good version of the thing. You want changes? I think I can sing a bit more.
No, the play's okay. It's this play what I'm worried about. Horatius, you are a good and loyal friend. And as a good and loyal friend, I must ask you for a favor.
Whatever is in my power, my lord.
Tonight, you will help me find out the identity of the killer of my father. Tonight, we will find out if that ghost was really my father, or just another fiend of hell.
You mean like a zombie? Because it didn't look like a zombie to me. It looked more like a classic ghost, you know, like...
Minotaurs! The thing is, there's a play being performed tonight. One of the scenes comes very close to describing the circumstances of my father's death. Watch my eye closely when that scene begins. If his guilty secret does not reveal itself, then that ghost was just a demon. And my depression is chronic. Well, how's my dear son doing, huh? Great! I've been eating air, like Kami used to. I'm positively stuffed with air.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Great! That makes two of us. Apollonia! Someone told me you used to act back at the university.
Indeed, my lord. I was considered quite a good actress.
And what role did you play?
I played Belma Kelly in Chicago. Hit it, boys! Apollonia!
God, no need to show us, please. We believe you. Miranda.
Yes. No need to show us. Please.
Very well, let's sit down.
Hamlet! Will you sit right beside your mother, please? Oh, Miranda!
No thanks, my good mother. I have a much more comfortable place. Here.
Oh, my God.
Do you mind if I rest my head in your lap?
I thought you did.
Don't do that!
What?
think. If you think too much, you'll go crazy, just like me.
Now, it is a pleasure to present to you the murder of Gonzalo, the untold story by the most amazing theater company. By Prince Hamlet.
So you are a writer, my dear. You see, Miranda, my little boy is a writer.
Oh, you're so lucky, my lady.
Very well, let's begin.
Stop! Stop! Stop!
He managed to fulfill this horrid act.
No!
my lord?
My lord, we were innocent. We demand.
Oh, but you are fantastic, brilliant. Oh, you're the best.
Oh, really? Well, we are. And you miss the end. The end is, I give to everyone. There is blood around. Violence.
Oh, I'm sure it's incredible.
Would you like to see it?
Why not?
Okay, company, finale! Finale!
My lord! Can we have a word with you?
Not just a word, a whole story. But now I'm about to see the end of it.
Finale!
My lord! We have a word with you.
Well, you will have to wait. We were here first.
But we come on behalf of the king, who is in his chambers now.
And he's very upset.
Mm-hmm.
What? An upset stomach for too much booze?
No, my lord, he's really angry.
Well, we come on behalf of the queen, who is also very upset.
Upset because she's angry, not because she's drunk. My lord, finale.
Oh, you're right, the finale. Please show us.
My lord, your mother is in talk with you now.
Very well. Tell my mother I will go in a minute. My friend, it seems that there will be no finale for me. But I'm sure my other friends would love to see it, right?
But your father's not Shanko!
He can wait.
Okay, finale!
Now it's time for the angel of justice! Die, you sinners!
My lady needs me to stay, or can I go mind my own business?
Miranda, why don't you go and mind your own business, please?
I'm sure everything will be okay.
Don't be afraid. I will put this sword here, in case you need it. And I will hide here, in case you need help. Why would I need any help?
Mother, I'm coming!
You're right, but I will hide here anyways.
Hello, mother? So what's the matter?
Hamlet, you have insulted your father.
Mother, you have insulted my father.
Hamlet, you have offended the king.
Mother, you have offended the king.
Hamlet, respect my husband.
Mother, you have to respect your husband.
What are you talking about? Are you hallucinating? Do you know who I am?
Oh, I know it very well. You're the queen.
Yes.
Your husband's brother's wife. My mother, and also eternal! Ah!
Don't speak to me like that! I don't have to put up with this.
Oh, yes, you have! You and I will settle things up! See here! What is this? A sword! Why do you need this, mother?
Oh my god, it wasn't my idea! Please don't kill me! It wasn't my idea! Please! Oh my god!
What is this, a rat? It's freaking dead rat!
Oh my god, what have you done? This is a terrible thing! Both of you laugh!
They are.
Is it as horrible, as King and King and Mary and his brother?
What are you talking about?
So pretending with the act, you know what that will happen to follow with number of gear. But I know now that the prison will use that prison was so and so near. Cause your mother, you will sit down and listen to me. I have something to tell you.
I was lonely, I was tired. I was being at the prison, so deep that my head started falling. Was I dying? For a queen without her is a monster. I was not prepared. I just see what I thought it was there.
Hey, I have nothing to do. Oh, Mother, why can't you be honest and tell me the truth?
You don't have so much fear. You've left another new friend. So much love to
give. Stop it, then stop with the act. No. You know what? That will happen to Father, but not very clear. But I know now that the person who did it, that person was so and so near. So, dear Mother, you will sit down and listen to me. I have something to tell you. Mother, you're a weak and awful woman. Oh, angels in heaven, bless me with your wings. What can I do for you, my gracious lord?
Oh my god, let's go to the insane!
What are you doing, son? You should be killing my treacherous brother, not upsetting your poor mother.
But she's guilty, she betrayed you.
Hamlet, who are you talking to? There is no one in here.
Your mother is in shock. Oh, help her, Hamlet. She's just a very sensitive woman who needs to be loved. Talk to her, Hamlet.
Don't worry. I will.
Hamlet!
Have this conversation all over again?
No, no.
Well then go, Mother.
I still have to find a place for her. God wanted to punish me with this murder, and her with me. So I'm both Ivan's executioner and his minister of justice.
Hamlet, but your Ash is dead and you're alive.
Mother, leave!
Okay, I'm sorry.
I've been married since the beginning, since every of four. I'm sure not to plan his plan for that treacherous foe. But first I must deal with his score. I must find a place where to hide her before I go on. Of the chamber with a golden shoulder and ready to set you prevent yourself. Be prepared for starting his story with masters without be the heir. So the audience, just in fact, I'll be left to your shoes that you will love our
Apollonia. It is very strange. She never misses a secret bloody meeting. Well, I have summoned you here because... Because the Hamlet situation is getting out of hands. Marsala!
A few minutes after we left him with the queen, we heard screaming. Strange noises.
Boom, boom, boom.
And a very tacky song. Thank you. The queen left the chamber in tears, like a lot of tears, and locked herself in the guest room.
It's very common for the sons to have a love-hate relationship with their mothers. It's a whole Oedipus thing.
This has nothing to do with Oedipus! A decision must be taken with Hamlet, and being you his friends, I will need support and collaboration. I believe Hamlet must leave Denmark!
But he loves it here!
That's why I need your help, to convince him and to escort him. He cannot be left alone.
And where will you send him, Your Majesty?
To England!
To England?
Yes. One more man will make no difference there.
Horror! Horror!
Ah, it's a tragedy! It's a tragedy! It's a tragedy! Ah, it's a tragedy! It's a tragedy! Ah, it's a tragedy!
Wait! What's going on?
She is dead.
Who is dead?
Who is dead?
Lady Apollonia is dead.
What? What happened?
I saw Prince Hamlet coming out of the queen's chamber. He was carrying something over his shoulder. It was the bleeding body of Lady Apollonia.
Ladies, control yourself. But was she dead?
That's why I asked the prince, and he answered, "Of course, she's dead, as both my fathers are." And then he left calling his friend Nicornicus to give him a hand with a package.
OMG! He killed her! Whoa! What do you know? We cannot imprison a prince, not in the Middle Ages.
He really needs to go!
Enough!
We need a more permanent solution to our problem.
But how can we stop being a man?
fire, my country's chaos because of one man. Blood and destruction because of one man. So Hamlet must die. For the sake of the nation, Prince Hamlet must die.
Must die, must die, Prince Hamlet must die.
He killed the Polonia, so Hamlet must die.
Must die, must die, Prince Hamlet must die.
Of course we're going! As you can imagine, I cannot kill my nephew's son here in Elsinore.
But you managed quite well with his father.
I mean, as a father, that is very considerate of you.
As soon as you arrive to the court, give this to Lord Richard of Gloucester. You know, the hunchback. He will take care of Hamlet. Now bring him to me!
Oh, Claudius, you can't imagine the incident I just had with Hamlet! Tell him, Miranda!
My lady just had the horrible incident with Hamlet.
Shut up, Miranda.
Yes.
I know. Don't worry. I will take care of Hamlet.
No, but he cannot go to prison. I know he killed Apollonia, but he's a prince and my son. And he cannot go to prison. Besides, killing is in fashion nowadays. Monarchs are killing their ministers all over Europe. Besides, Apollonia was an annoying human being.
Oh, yes. She was so annoying, she deserved to die.
Relax, my love. He will not go to jail. But we will send him away.
Yes, far, far, far away. Far.
She means far away as in England, far away.
Yes. The girls will escort Hamlet to England, and he will remain there until things calm down here and he composes himself.
What a great idea. You're such a good father. Can you believe in his madness? Hamlet accused you of Joseph Aurelius' death. Of course I didn't believe a word. Why would you betray your own brother and steal his throne and his family?
Ambition is a good reason, my lady.
You're wrong, Miranda. Claudius, are you ambitious?
Of course not, my love.
You see, Miranda, Claudius is not ambitious. Therefore, you are wrong again! Wrong, loser! Claudius is nothing but a sensitive human being.
My lord! We can get him to tell us where he put the body!
Hamlet! Where is Apollonia?
At dinner!
At dinner where?
Not where she eats, but where she's eaten. A certain convocation of political worms is chewing her ideas away, among other things.
Hamlet, where is Apollonia?
In heaven! You can send a message there if you're not sure. But if your messenger can't find her, you can always go check hell yourself. But seriously, don't worry. If you don't find her within a month, you'll be sure to smell her as you go up the stairs into the main hall.
Hurry up! Look for her!
Oh, but there's no need to hurry! She's not going anywhere!
Hamlet, I care for you as much as I grieve for Apollonia. For your own protection, I must send you to England at once. So get ready to live. The ship is set to sail. Your friends will go with you.
Oh, lucky me. I always wanted to visit London. Can I take Unicornicus with us?
Of course Unicornicus can go with you. Get well, my love.
You too, mother. See ya.
I hope he gets well.
I'm sure Hamlet will find peace in London. He will rest in peace there.
Hola. But I'm going banana. I once had a lover. He was not just cute like the one of someone that is loved by my mother. I must find me another. Who knows what happened to her brain? That girl has gone insane. And there's no comeback. We must hurry over to growing bananas. So book me a woman of common pleaser with all my bananas. But I'm going bananas.
She lost it, Your Highness.
What do you mean, she lost it?
She lost it! Thief! No more! Wacky Wacky! She flew directly to Cuckoo Land. We're keeping her company until Laertes arrives.
Poor girl. She was never very stable.
You're right, and nothing like having your ex-boyfriend killing your mother to go from unstable to wacky.
Olivia!
No, if you excuse me, I must leave. She gets really upset if someone misses the choreography.
Oh, poor girl. Love can be so cruel sometimes.
Oh, yes. Love can be so cruel.
We must prepare for when Laertes receives the news of her mother's death.
Where is the king?
My God, news do travel fast in Europe nowadays.
Where is my mother? Mother! Mother! Mommy! Mommy! Mommy!
Laertes! I believe you have heard about the nasty rumors of your mother's unfortunate incident.
There was no unfortunate incident. Your...
I know it's so sad, but you knew she had problems.
No, I didn't.
Well, she had. Right, brother?
Yes, my lady. Problems.
Oh, I'm in shock. But first things first. I demand to know what happened to my mother. And if there is someone to blame, I want him punished.
Well, Laertes, the truth is that...
Gia, wait! You can't go like that! You will ruin the dress! Ophelia! Oh, wait!
Wait! What is going on?
Where did she go?
Oh, there's nothing to worry about.
Well, she will ruin the dress, I tell you that.
What are you talking about? Where did she go?
She went for a swim in the lake.
We told her to change into a bathing suit, but she ran away.
My sister doesn't swim.
Ophelia! Ophelia!
I'm going bananas. I don't think I can.
from the ghost. I think it's from Prince Hamlet.
You opened it?
Of course I did. I'm a messenger.
Leave.
My friend, you won't believe the incredible stories every city has to be. We pulled the ship that night, crossed the sea, headed to London at right. When suddenly pirates boarded the ship and began to start a fight. Oh, of course, the pirates won. They were much better winning than all the chaps.
The musical version, right? The musical version needs musical numbers.
Just get on with the story, will you?
The pirates captured our ship. We were made prisoners. While looting off things, they found Claudius' letter to Prince Richard of Gloucester, in where he asks him to kill me.
Yes, Horatius,
to kill. Pirates asked me why the King of Denmark wanted me killed. Yes, Horatius, they speak funny. And there, Horatius, in a stroke of genius, I told them I was a famous criminal. And that Rosencrantz and Guildenstern were two officers taking me to my execution. The pirates, believing my story and out of solidarity to a fellow criminal, set me free and killed Rosencrantz and Guildenstern. Yes, Horatius, Rosencrantz and Guildenstern are dead. I'll be arriving tomorrow. You'll find two letters for the king. Be sure he receives them and meet me at the cemetery. Your friend, Hamlet. Bye-bye.
Give this letter to the king, now.
You must understand, Laertes, that I'm not your enemy. I want justice to be served with Hamlet as much as you do. But the queen's a very fragile woman, and any direct action was impossible. Trust me, Richard of Gloucester is a vicious man. He will take care of Hamlet in a very painful way.
Still, I was supposed to kill him. My mother, my vengeance.
Justice, Laertes, is justice, not vengeance.
My lord, from Prince Hamlet.
What?
What? You run from the tomb?
Leave us! Leave us!
So it is from Hamlet. Is he dead? Is he?
No, he's not dead!
But you promised!
Something interfered in my bench. Justice.
Interfered? You assured me he was dead.
And he will be. Once you kill him.
What?
Yes, Hamlet's back at Denmark and wants to return to Elsinore. I will allow him to do that. Once in the castle, we will celebrate his arrival with a fencing match.
What kind of idiot do you think I am? This is the way I avenge my mother and sister, by celebrating the comeback of their killer?
Laertes, you don't understand. You will be Hamlet's rival in the fencing match. Hamlet so careless and unsuspecting, he would not check the swords beforehand. So you can easily grab one with a sharpened point and in one thrust avenge the death of your mother by your own hands.
Good. And to be extra sure he will die, I will put some potion on the sword tip. Just a superficial cut will be enough.
And to be extra sure he will die, I will serve him a little drink. So if he escapes the sword and the poison in the sword, the poison in the drink will kill him.
And drink extra.
I think that's enough, Laertes. Come on, we must attend your sister's funeral.
Oh, God. With all these revenge preparations, I forgot she was dead. My poor Ophelia, you have got too much water already. So I won't cry anymore. Let's go.
fears.
Oh, I hate this job!
Well, it pays well.
Of course, because nobody wants to do it. Stop complaining and hurry up!
He will appear very soon.
Oh, I hate this job, I hate this job, I hate this job!
Excuse me, sir, but you can be here, only authorized personnel.
I am Prince Hamlet. I have returned to Elsinore to serve justice.
I'm so happy for you. But she has got to do before he arrives, so please be on your way.
Who's to be buried in this grave?
One who used to be a woman.
And now she's not, so if you excuse us, we need to finish and leave.
Her name?
Odelia, Odelia, Emilia.
Ophelia!
Yeah, that's her, Ophelia.
Poor girl, she went swimming.
But Ophelia doesn't know how to swim.
Oh, right.
Oh no, Ophelia!
Oh no, oh no, 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 no. This is all your fault. We didn't finish and now he's here. I hate this job.
What is going on? What is this music?
This music, this king is coming.
Yeah, he always brings his music with him.
Yes, it is music, ghosts, skeletons, you name it. They all come with him, and I don't like ghosts, I don't like skeletons, and I hate this job.
Again, Father, is that you? It's Reed, Father, it's Hamlet. I'm here, Father, talk to me, appear to me.
It's not your father, it's your ring. Your father's old jester.
Excuse me, Prince Hamlet.
Yes?
My lord, the king, your father, received your letters and wants you to know you're welcome to return to Elsinore.
Well, tell the king, my uncle, that I will be arriving soon.
My lord, the king, your father, wants you to know he has spoken with Laertes and the unfortunate incident regarding his mother Apollonia is now in the past.
Well, tell the king, my uncle, that I have no problem facing justice.
My lord, the king, your father, recognizes there is no need for that. You are a prince and his beloved son, and nobody likes Apollonia, so there is no need for a trial. Laertes will accept your apologies, and to put everything behind, he has agreed to have a fencing match against you tomorrow. Can I tell the king, your father, that you will attend this match and apologize to Laertes?
Now listen to me, you little piece of excruciating piece of human matter! The king is my uncle, not my dad, my uncle, and as I have told you 100 times, now, I will be attending the fencing match and apologizing to Laertes in order to bring peace to our country. Understood?
Yes, I will tell the king. Your father!
Song of the day,
my
No way! There will be no song! And we go to the last scene, now!
But I... We have rehearsed a musical number!
There will be no musical number, but the finale! The people want to know how the play ends!
Come on! They know how Hamlet ends! It's the most famous play in history of theater! They know the end! Right?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll do your ending.
Farewell! Ladies and gentlemen! This is the end of Haha Hamlet!
Here's the thrill I was just fantasy. Caught her in this little escape from this tragedy. Open your eyes, look up to the stage and see. Hamlet's a poor boy, he has no sympathy because I'm easy go, easy go, little heart, little hope, and you were doing blows. Doesn't really matter to him.
Very well! Have your family seal the peace, let my son defend the cause of the house. With this sword, a toast for Hamlet! Well done, son. Come on, Artis, I know you can do better.
Batman has killed my dad. Put some poison in his head. Now he's here, now he's dead. Bow! Time now for revenge to start. See how I will free all their souls.
For the sword that Gareth had poisoned. Like the drink you all got.
Nothing really matters. Anyone can see. Nothing really matters.
Así que vamos a darle speed al final. Pero me parece que es importante en la última función. Me gusta agradecer a los chicos que ya han ganado el aplauso, pero sobre todo presentar al equipo de gente que trabaja para que esto llegue acá arriba. Este ha sido un año maravilloso, una obra increíble. Hamlet es una obra increíble y la verdad que transformarla en una comedia fue muy divertido para todos nosotros. Espero que lo haya sido para ustedes. Y nada, quiero presentar al equipo que trabaja hace muchos años de arriba, Andrea Pacheco, coreógrafa. A Morita, nuestra preparadora vocal. A la persona que nada, mucho más. Dice conmigo, está acá siempre, es el pulmón, la rueda de auxilio, es todo. Miley, adelante. A Ale Peralta, que está organiza backstage de producción general, está aquí atrás. Este año hemos tenido el placer y la alegría de tener banda en vivo. Una banda de exalumnos, todos salidos de acá, de este mismo recinto, y ese es el chiche del amigo George Valiente, y ahí está. Gracias, George. Y bueno, agradecer por supuesto a toda la estructura del colegio, a los profes, a esta semana se vuelve un poco loco secundaria porque nosotros venimos acá casi todos los días. A los padres también, porque sepan que nosotros sabemos que esto no sería posible sin el apoyo de ustedes, que los traen, que los llevan, que se adaptan un poco a estos horarios medios locos. Y del cole, que nos dan muchísima libertad para poder hacer este tipo de cosas. Muchas gracias, nos vemos el año que viene. Hasta luego.